for my special, special guests, BeBe and CeCe Winans and Miss Gladys. Hope you're ready. Think that was something. And you move your dial. Your problem. Good evening. You've already met my guest tonight, and really that's just a sample of what we got in store for you. Gladys Knight is truly one of my dearest friends in our business or out of our business. I consider her absolute family. Yes, indeed. And as well, BeBe and CeCe Winans are also family. So we're going to kind of call this evening a family affair. Yes. We're going to share some inside tidbits with you. Lots and lots of music. So don't you go away. We will be right back. Well, we're back with three people that I love very, very much. BeBe and CeCe Winans, mm-hmm. and Miss Gladys Nye. Listen, girl, we've been all over the world since I last saw you.
And
we got a lot of catching up to do. I want all you to know that Gladys, Patty, and I will be going out on tour together as Sisters in the Name of Love very soon. Yeah.
I know you've been hearing that, but it's the truth.
It's gonna happen. We finally got it together. And also that Gladys is now in the process of putting together the next Sisters in the Name of Love television show for us to do again.
Yep.
You've been busy.
Yeah, I'm hanging it there for us.
Me. And I also know that you did not come prepared to sing. I understand, you know.
I got a cold.
I don't understand.
I got the flu.
You ain't got no flu. I got the flu. You ain't got no flu. But I think if I started this, you might want to jump in. And I never thought I'd see you this way. And as far as I'm concerned, glad I got the chance to say, see, and I do believe.
Yeah. held on me.
For sure,
for sure. You see, that's what friends are for. You know, that's what friends are for.
This Gladys night. We'll be right back. Here are two people who know their way around a song. And as anybody knows, their future continues to get brighter. Please welcome two of my favorite people in the world, BeBe and CeCe Winans. Hey, I love you.
Y'all just soothe the soul.
Thank you.
I love you.
Come from you guys, that's a compliment.
Well, honey, listen, I'm saying you just produced mom and dad.
Yes.
Mom
and dad is our number.
Really?
Look out.
I mean, an honor. They put their careers on the side for their children and supported us our lives, and now they went into studio, and it was a hilarious thing to see my father, to know my father is to know Bill Cosby has nothing on. But just to see them coming in the studio and do what they do, and they can sing.
I know that. I mean, in the way we're going to have how many children in the family? And every single one of you. Every single one of you. Ain't no way in the world that's going to happen without them being able to sing. Now, they're both ministers, right?
My father is, and my mom is, she plays the piano and sings at the church.
Faithful members. We thank God for them because they trained us that way. We had to go to church.
But that's what's missing in our young people today.
I
had to go to church too. You know?
And it gives
you something to hold on to.
It gives you a base. You know? For sure. And it goes with you. No matter where you go, how old you get, you remember it.
Yeah.
That's right. And look what happened to us.
Mm-hmm.
We were all raised that way, and that's all we know.
Right.
That's all I want to know.
Yeah. That's right. Thank you. Oh, honey. We're gonna tell that. We're gonna really tell that story one day, so somebody can really hear us, and we're gonna do it at length. You know, I got it up here. Don't worry about it.
And if anybody can put it together, she can. That's for sure. You stay where you are. We'll be back with our walk of fame. The person we honor tonight is Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Yes, indeed. He sought to bring about social, political, and economic equality for black people. He gave his energy, his time, and eventually his life to that cause. And it is because of his dedication and his ability to inspire that we are where we are today. Beginning with the Montgomery boycott in 1957, that was for equality and sitting where you wanted to sit on a bus. The many demonstrations in the late 50s and early 60s, the March on Washington in 1963, Dr. King was in the forefront of the movement for nonviolent social change. It was Dr. King's voice and persona that kept us calm and ever mindful of our goals. In 1964, he was awarded the Nobel Peace Prize, perhaps the highest honor that could be awarded to any individual. But Dr. King's life wasn't about awards or recognition for himself. He looked at life itself as an opportunity for change. Though it's difficult to think about his tragic assassination in 1968, he will be remembered not as a martyr, but as a man who brought this country to its senses, its feet, and perhaps closer to his dream. It's an honor to add his name to our Walk of Fame. Exactly what happened. I certainly had a great time and do hope that you enjoyed it as much as I did. It's a very special show for me tonight. And I do want to thank BeBe and CeCe and Gladys for making it just that special. I want you to be where you are next week because we have a great show for you then too. So until that time, would you come in and say goodbye with me? Bye.
Here's to you.